Good afternoon. I'm Anne Connolly, I'm a local GP. I'm also the clinical lead for women's health across Bradford and Airedale. And here I am today to talk a little bit about breast cancer awareness. So October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and today, the 13th of October, is Breast Cancer Awareness Day. Why is breast cancer so important? Well, it is because it is the commonest cancer in the UK. 1 in 8 of us women will get breast cancer in our lifetime. Outcomes for breast cancer are improving every year, but that's usually about raising awareness about breast cancer, getting it found early, and going and seeing, getting onto some treatment. So there are some shocking stats. One person in the UK every 10 minutes will be diagnosed with breast cancer. And in this month alone, 5,000 people in the UK will be diagnosed with this condition. Mostly women are affected, but we mustn't forget that occasionally men can also be affected. So when I'm talking about breast cancer, when I'm talking about checking your breasts and lifestyle changes, this is also relevant for men. And if a man notices a lump or a change to the nipple or discharge from the nipple, then they need to go and see their GP. Breast cancer also runs in some families. And so some families will have a strong family history of breast cancer, ovarian cancer, and possibly bowel cancer. Now, if you have several members in your immediate family or one first degree relative, so that's your mum or your sister or your father, then you also should go and talk to your GP about whether you are at high risk yourself and whether you should go through additional checks to find out. So what can we do to help ourselves prevent getting breast cancer? We certainly can't change our family history, but what we can do is some of the lifestyle lifestyle choices that we make. Four in ten cancers can be caused by lifestyle choices. And for breast cancer, this is usually about if you smoke, if you're overweight, or if you drink too much alcohol. They are all things that you can change. Again, more information like this on the internet, and we will be putting the relevant resource links below this short talk. Other things we can do, well, you can check your breasts, and if you notice any changes to the breast, then you can again go and see your GP to discuss whether or not you need further investigations. Now, on the website, again, there is a good resource telling us how to check our breasts, and there are some little YouTube clips as well that are very helpful for this. The first thing to do is to stand in front of a mirror and to look at your breasts, to check the shape of them. Put your hands behind your head so that you lift them and notice if there's any skin tethering, and put your hands on the waist, and that will give you a good look at the different, the way the breasts appear. But then when you check your breasts, it's with the flat of your hand, and it's about going round the breast to see if you can feel any lumps or any bumps or any changes. It's also going around the nipple, and finally up into the armpit there to see if there are any lumps there, and then obviously doing the same on the other side. Doing that regularly allows you to understand what your own breasts feel like, and then if there are any changes, then you can consider going and talking to your GP for them to check. And then the last point about getting investigations or getting the breasts checked more formally is by going for your mammogram. For women, we get called for a mammogram between the ages of 50 and 70 every 3 years. There are programs that will perform mammograms younger age or an over age, but then you have to go into a special system for that. The letter will come through the post with your appointment. Lots of women don't attend their mammograms, which is very concerning, because if you did find a lump early, then as we say, the outcomes are much better. And why did women tell us they don't go for their mammograms? Well, they're concerned about who's doing it. They're concerned about how embarrassing it's going to be. They're concerned about the pain. Firstly, the screeners are all women. They treat you very discreetly, and the procedure doesn't last very long. It is uncomfortable, but the screeners will make it as easy to do as possible, and the whole process only takes a few minutes. The results come through the post very quickly, and then if there are any concerns, then you'll be forwarded straight on to the hospital. Now, the hospitals these days, they run a one-stop clinic. So if you do go to have any further tests, it's all done on one day. It's not going backwards and forwards for different tests. Now, as I've said, there are lots of information around breast cancer on the website. The resources are listed below. There is also one there on Bradford Hospital Service, which explains to you exactly what you would expect to happen if you do go, if you do need to go on for some further tests. So this is Breast Cancer Awareness Day. Please start checking your breasts. Please start thinking about whether or not you need to go for your mammogram if you've missed it, and contact your GP who can make you that appointment if you have. Thank you for listening.